G'day all, Mr. Paladin here. And as I have played Team Fortress 2 more and more, I'm reminded about the different types of gamers that there are and the different goals we have in the game. I recall the Bartle test that was made based on a 1996 paper by Richard Bartle. The purpose of this test is to try and work out what type of gamer you are and what type of gamer is playing the game you're making. I recently started playing more Guild Wars 2. The types of players in a massive multiplayer online RPG are the core users that Bartle was originally talking about as games shifted from a single player into multiplayer environments. Now, the Bartle test itself is met with some criticism because of the way the test is conducted and its line of questioning, but I find there are many truths to the result of the test. The main crux of the test is that there are basically four types of gamers: the achievers, the explorers, the socializers, and the killers. And you can have a bit of four of them impacting your own gameplay. Achievers are players who prefer to gain points, levels, equipment, or actual achievements within the games. These are concrete measurements in succeeding in the game. They will go to great lengths to achieve rewards that confer to them little or no gameplay benefit, simply for the prestige of having it. In single player games, this may give them a bonus ending or a greater completion rating. In Team Fortress 2, we see some of it with the actual Team Fortress 2 achievements, the collecting of items, the different item levels, or the special effects, which have nothing to do with the gameplay, over the lower grade items that don't have the special effects. The prestige of owning these items is satisfying. Now, the explorers like to discover new areas. They like maps with hidden places or Easter eggs. They often like open world games where they are not time restricted. Finding glitches or map faults are interesting to this player. In single player games, the combat is secondary to this user, so they might enjoy games like Myst where you have to solve puzzles. Half-Life 2 had moments of this where you had to try and solve gameplay physics problems before advancing, and there was no combat when that moment happened. Explorers like doing things that the programmers did not think about. Sometimes breaking outside of the maps or outside of the confines of the rules is appealing to the explorer. Outside of Team Fortress 2 in multiplayer games, an explorer will often mingle with each other in order to share ways around places, to solve puzzles, to find ways around the map. Interacting with a killer, who we'll talk about later, tend to always be negative, so they'll stick to player versus environment more than competition or player versus player. Explorers may play a less mainstream title for years, but abandon a very popular game in a matter of days. Socializers play the game for its social aspect rather than the game itself. They like interacting with other players. They prefer roleplay or acting like their characters in the game as a tool to mingle with the other people that they might meet outside of the game. They would like to form groups with other like-minded players and interact with them on all levels to learn more about the other people. Online games are very appealing to socializers as the number of people you can meet are near limitless. And this often extends into private messages and voice chatting with the people offline. They will often help other people out and make new friends. They will make tutorials. Eventually, socializers will become well known in their home servers or in their gaming community, either by the services they provide or maybe the drama they are involved in. I'm going to gut you like a Cornish kid. Lastly, the killers. They thrive on competition with other players and prefer combat with real people other than combat versus the AI, because the AI eventually becomes too basic to work out, even in more difficult games. The artificial intelligence that you fight has its limitations, and killers will work that out very quickly. In single player games, a killer will often depart from being a good guy and prefer playing the anti-hero or maybe even the villain. In sandbox games, they like playing the role of the person who has a direct hand in building or destroying a virtual society. In multiplayer games, causing direct mayhem may appeal to some, but not all killers. Player versus player areas can be found with killers preying on the other archetypes of gamers. And for the most part, the explorers, the achievers, and the socializers accept that killers are a part of the game they love. Killers are in it for the sport, and some are very good sports about it. They go looking into competitive gaming and ranking against each other. Trying to read their opponents and playing honorable within the rules of the game is often very appealing. For other killers, it's simply the thrill of the hunt. Ganking, owning, camping, trolling, or even cheating is not beyond the realm of their acceptable behavior. And the rules of the game are often stretched to their limits. Repeatedly stalking or picking off a particular target while allowing others to remain ignored is quite common. Killers do play a role in the social and economic sides of the multiplayer game. Some killers like to even read the markets. A bored killer can often be a threat to a community and can manifest an abrasive attitude that can stir up trouble even when they don't mean to. So what kind of gamer are you? Are you a healthy mix of all four, or do you trend to be one of the archetypes? Have you seen the other archetypes in game, and do you handle each of them differently? Do you let the explorer try and explore? Do you try and match wits with the other killers? Do you want to reach all those achievements? Or are you part of a guild, or a group, or a cult, or a clan? Try taking the battle test. I'm going to link it in the comments section below to try and see what you think and what you find out about yourself. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Here I think a spy is coming up, but he's a teammate. He lets me know. And we're redisguising when a pirate turns up on the scene. So I make a play at it. It was a low-risk situation, I had my dead ringer ready. Here's another case where I get risky with a really close decloak, hoping no one hears it, but the demo man, even though he has action, he turns around. So I have to pull off a matador in a corner.